Commercial cleaning business, do's and don'ts. Hi, I'm Steve Hansen, co-founder of the janitorialstore.com. Well, you know, as you're building your commercial cleaning business, there's some things that you should be doing and some things you should not be doing. So I've compiled a list of some do's and don'ts. First, I'm gonna discuss the do's. So the first thing that we should always do is that we should always select the sectors that we're gonna service. Too many people, you know, they'll start a commercial cleaning company and they have no idea who they're going to service. So you want to think about that. So you got five sectors. You got your professional office buildings, you got medical, you got educational, you got manufacturing, you got retail. So it's a good idea for you to have to know which of those sectors you're going to service. I would suggest that you always start off with professional office buildings and then expand from there. So that's always a good place to start. Something else you want to do is you want to get involved with networking groups. Because if we can build our network of people that we know and become an influencer, that means that we can open up a lot more doors for ourselves and for others. And the nice thing about that is when you do get involved with networking groups, things do happen. I know that to be a fact. I've always done that whenever I've started one of my commercial cleaning companies. I've always got involved with networking groups, and I got involved is the key word. I talked to some business owners that tell me, well, networking doesn't work. Well, okay, when was the last time you went to an event? Well, it's been a while. Well, you have to get involved with networking, and you have to work it. You just can't sit to the side and not do anything except everybody to come and talk to you. So that's why I always say that with networking, you got to have a goal when you attend a networking event. And that should be to at least meet five new people. So what that does is that gets you off your chair and it gets you out there mingling and talking with people and introducing yourself. So that's what you want to do. Something else that you should do is develop systems. Now, it doesn't matter if we got a cleaning business, or if we're a plumbing business or a construction business or whatever, it just doesn't matter. All companies got to run on systems. And if you were to develop systems, you're going to find that your business is going to run a lot more smoothly. So what I mean by systems is that you're going to typically work off of the five core pillars of business. And from those five core pillars, you're going to develop systems within those pillars. For HR, you might have a system for hiring and onboarding. Then you may have another one for sales and marketing under sales that you're going to develop a sales process. And what you're doing is you're outlining the step-by-step process in how you complete something. You know, what is your sales process? How do you start that? You know, we go here and we do this. And, you know, what are the steps? You have to document that. So that's very, very important. So always be developing systems. Now, something else you always got to do is that you do have to have training in place. It's interesting, the number of commercial cleaning business owners that I talk to that don't have training in place, some of them just outright don't believe in training their employees, which is a big mistake. I don't really understand that, but you know, I'm sure they're having challenges with it. And to be honest with you, typically they'll tell me that they're having high turnover and they're having other issues within the company. And it all comes back to the lack of training, lack of engagement for your team. So I just can't place enough emphasis on that. We have to train, we have to engage, and we have to continue to do personal development for our team. Very important. So that's our do side. And there could be many more. Maybe you can think of a couple more. And if you do, you know, go ahead and post them in the comments below. Now let's talk about the things that you don't want to do. So I highly recommend that people don't do any retail cleaning. The problem is that there's just no money in it. Over the years we've seen it decline. In fact, we have some clients that are getting out of that market just because of that reason. So. No use in going out and getting jobs just to practice your cleaning. We're in business to make a profit, so I would stay away from residential. or stay away from retail. Something else that you don't want to do is don't lower your price to get the job. You know, I'll talk to some business owners that are relatively new, and you know, I understand that we got to get some business, we got to get some revenue coming in, so we're pretty hungry, so we're willing to lower our price just to get the job. Well, that's just not a good idea. You don't need to do that, first of all. So, you know, and don't fall into the trap where, let's say if you're talking to a prospect and they're telling you, well, gosh, Steve, you know, depending on where your price comes in on this job, I may have 5 more jobs. Don't fall for that. All that is a strategy for them to get you to lower your price. You're never going to get the 5 other jobs. Been there, done that, you know. So, you know, I'm sharing experiences that I had with myself, and it doesn't work. So don't do that anymore. And in fact, you know, that'd probably make another good video on, you know, what's your strategies, how to overcome all that. But anyway, just don't lower your price just to get a job. And something else that we don't want to do is don't wait so long to follow up with a prospect. So let's say we went and we presented a proposal to the prospect. Whenever you go and you present your proposal to them, you should always set a follow-up date. So before you leave that meeting, make sure you set a follow-up date. And it shouldn't be no less than 5 days. So let them know that you're going to be coming, you know, that you'll meet with them again within 5 days, you know, and select a date and a time. And now you got your appointment set. So set the date. Something else that we don't want to do is, and I often see this in both residential and commercial, is that the business owner will start hiring employees, but yet they don't have their systems in place, such as the hiring system, a training system, they don't have a policy manual. You don't want to do that. That's setting you up for failure, and also it could be litigation. So you got to remember that you want to do things in order. So before you hire an employee, make sure you got a company policy manual. You can find those on the Janitorial Store and My House Cleaning Biz. In fact, if you're a member of My House Cleaning Biz or the janitorialstore.com, you know, you get a company policy manual. You can go in, you edit it, and make it your own. But, you know, you got to have one. And if you go and try to hire that out, you know, it's going to cost you probably over $3,000 for that policy manual. So, you know, take a look at the membership, and you're going to agree that the investment is well worth it. And the other thing that you have to do is you've got to make sure that you have training in place. It really makes no sense for us not to have any training in place, but yet hire somebody and try to just, you know, shoot from the hip and have them shadow us for weeks or months. And some people have told me that, well, typically I just have them follow me for a month, then I let them go or whatever. But you want to have a formal training program. And again, you're going to find these things. All these tools are right on the janitorialstore.com. So, you know, why recreate the wheel? Everything's there. These are proven systems that, you know, thousands of cleaning businesses have used. So, you know, check it out and make sure before you hire anybody that you have your company policy manual and you got training systems in place. It's going to make it so much smoother for you. You definitely got to have a hiring system in place, you know, which I mean by that is your whole entire hiring system where you start to place the ad till you offer the position, but then you have to have an onboarding too. By having these in place, it will make your life so much easier. Things will go so much smoother. So, there you go. These are the do's and don'ts for a commercial cleaning business. So hopefully you found this helpful. You know, if you did, go ahead and click on the like and share button. And as usual, if you have not subscribed to our channel yet, go ahead and click on the subscribe button. And you'll find hundreds and hundreds of videos on how to build a successful commercial cleaning business. So until next time, we'll see ya.